everybody, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today is going to be a continuation from where I stopped the other day. I think I stopped on Thursday. Today is a Sunday, so I'm gonna be continuing from where I stopped from the previous video. So today I'm gonna tell you how I came across, because the previous post I talked about people talking about nursing while I was in the CNA class, and I was not even motivated. I was like, no, I just want to get done with this class and get it over with. So today I'm going to be talking about what happened, what made me change my mind. On this fateful day, I was just walking as usual and I saw something. I'm gonna put the link at the top about finish your class in 8 weeks. That's like 2 months. I was so, this is impossible back home. Like, come on, in Nigeria, you're taking 4 weeks class? No, it's not possible. You have to sit down and take weeks and months of classes. And what class? I didn't ask. I didn't bother. I just want to finish it. I don't really like look for some things that are not necessary. I don't try to find answers to some things that are not important. Finding answer to what class is not even important to me. It may be important to another person, but I didn't even bother asking anyone what class it is. I was just like, you can actually finish a class? Naija, you go finish one class for 6 weeks, eight weeks. I have to take that class that I'm gonna be taking. I don't want to sit at home. Even though I have a job, I feel like I still need to do something. Like, yeah, let me take this class. It's 8 weeks. I'm gonna be done in 8 weeks. So I went in. I was like, I saw a bill, like a something like an advert or whatever that says finish your class in 8 weeks. So they explained to me, you have to take a placement test, and when you take a placement test, it's gonna determine where you're at. So I was like, okay, placement test, let's do it. So they gave me a date. I went in on the date. I don't even know what to study. I was studying Nigerian English and the little math that I know, because I actually hate math. So everybody that know me know that I hate math. That's the reason I didn't do sciences in the first place. So I went in, I did my placement test. I felt like I failed, because having bachelor's in English from Nigeria, and then they placed me in English 101 class. I was like, oh damn, like I really didn't listen in that class. if I could be placed in English 101 here, I was thinking they'll take out all my English classes and tell me, oh, you don't have to do English anymore. Then let's take you to math class and other classes that you have to do. But I did English 101 over again. So I did English 101, I did English 102. But one thing, I'm gonna be talking about the classes that I took and what happened next. What I want you to know about me is, I walked into Kennedy King College, fine. I saw the board and I was motivated by just an advert. That's me. I'm a very curious person. I want to know what is going on there, not because I have a special mission. Me walking into Kennedy King College to make inquiries about how to get, I just want to see, like, what the hell are you guys teaching for 8 weeks? Like, this is impossible. But then I went in there, I took the 8 weeks class. That's like a summer class. I'm very sure they were specific in the thing that I saw, but I didn't read that. I only saw 8 weeks and I went for it. So I took the class, it was only 8 weeks. My class was like, I went there to play. I'm an Australian class and I just went to play in that class, because after all, I had rigorous classes from the University of Ilorin in English already. So that class was like nothing. So I passed with a flying color. Then I had to take another class. My summer class was done. The next class was supposed to be like a 4 months class. And that was when I was like, okay, but I already got started with something. So I don't want to stop. I had to continue doing it. So the next class was 102, English 102. And I did English 102. And that was like, boom. And meanwhile, I don't know what I was doing. I was just taking classes. But they only told me for you to take 102, you have to do 101, and the next class is this is math. And I was just randomly taking classes. I don't have any education about what to do, what I'm going to do with these classes that I'm doing. But then I was lucky to take the right classes for nursing. See how miracle works. I was very lucky. I did English 101, English 102, Math 118, and then I did Chemistry 121. So these are the prerequisites for nursing, my dear. These are perfect prerequisites. That was all I did. But I was in a chemistry class, and one of the lady in my classes came up and was like, Habiba, what are you doing? Like, are you taking teas? I was like, teas? Teas. Like teas. T-E-A. Like, I don't want to mess up, but then in my mind I was like, if I ask stupid question, like this lady's gonna look at me like, okay, she. So I had to call her to the side and ask her what is this, and she told me this is the exam you have to take. It's like a like entrance exam to get to nursing, and I'm sorry. That was funny to me because I don't even know there's supposed to be any teas to get into nursing. And I was like, okay, how do I do teas? And then she told me, you have to register online, you have to pay this amount of money, then when you pay, they're gonna schedule a date for you. And I registered right there. And I don't even know what I'm going there to do, but I registered. I went, I think the date they gave me was a Saturday or something. So my husband helped me keep my son while I go do the exam. But prior to doing the exam, I met one Nigerian brother in the library of my school. So he was like, I saw him in school uniform. I was like, Daddy, Uncle Sir, you know, please. I see that you're wearing a nursing uniform. Are you doing nursing? He looks Nigerian. So I was very nice with him. I was like, oh, please, Daddy, me, please, like my daddy, please. Are you doing nursing? And he was like, yeah, he just graduated nursing. He's trying to see what he can do because he's trying to study for NCLEX. That's why he is here. I was like, NCLEX, what is NCLEX? I was like, NCLEX is like an exam you have to do when you're done with nursing. I was like, oh, you have to do an exam again when you're done with your classes and pass. I was like, okay, now I want to do nursing, sir. It was where are you from? I was like, are you a Muslim? I was like, yes, and he was a Muslim too, so he was very happy and welcoming. And he was like, well, I'm going to give you somebody's number, she'll tell you the classes to go so you can study for the TEAS exam, ATITs. So she gave me a sister's number, and then the sister put me through how to go through the readings and all that. Then that's how I passed. So that's how I passed this. And I don't even know what I'm going to do next. I never knew people were actually applying to my school, the school that I'm actually going. They're applying to TEAS exam from that, like online or somewhere else. I don't know. I don't know. You have to take any NCLEX after. I was like, oh, sir, you have to do NCLEX again after you're done with the nursing classes. I don't know how rigorous the nursing classes is. Anyways, I was like, so you have to do another exam? And he was like, yeah, you have to do that. And I started and I passed. So I went to the department of. He told me. Then I called him on the phone. That sir, I passed TSO. And he was like, oh yeah, congratulations, that was easy for you, right? I was like, no, he wasn't. But then I was like, that's just the entrance to nursing. Nursing shouldn't be that hard. Is it not about just giving abere and giving shots and giving injection? That's all about it. I don't think it should be that difficult. I look at nurses like, why are you guys doing shakara? Like, why are you guys doing like that? Like, shoot, is it not about giving shots? That's how I look at nurses. But then I got into the, he told me that I had to apply online to get into the nursing program. I was like, okay, what am I supposed to do with the test that I did? And he explained to me that now that I passed it, I have to use that and include it in my application, because there's going to be a spot in the application that I have to put the score that I had for math, for English, for sciences, and all that. So he put me through that, and I actually went online. You have to pay for that too. I paid, even though I don't have enough money, but I was just doing something. I don't know. Something was just pushing me to my glory. I applied, and it says closing. That same day that I was applying was the last day to apply. I applied, and I still went into the nursing department to let them know that, please, I applied to this, and it's telling me it's the last day. I'm not sure that I did the right thing. And the director of nursing then, she told me to wait, sit down, and I did. And she went through the whole application papers that she has. And she was like, well, I don't have your name. What's your GPA? Man, my GPA was a bomb. I had 3.96 something. And she was like, well, you don't even have to apply it online. I'm going to give you paper to fill out right here. And you have an admission already, baby. And I was like, that's all I have to do? She was like, did you pay online? I was like, yeah, okay, you did everything. I was like, yeah, okay, that's it. Give her something. Like, she told the secretary that I gave her something for her to know that I promised her an admission to nursing program. I was like, I was not ready for that commitment. I wasn't ready for the commitment, but I don't know what happened. I don't know what was pushing me. And I got an admission. Woo! I don't know if I was supposed to celebrate myself or get excited or go home and cry. I got home. I told my husband about what happened. My husband was advising me about his experience with nursing program, that I need to sit up tight, and I can't keep quiet. I already told everybody that I'm doing nursing. This was one thing that helped me. Because I can't keep quiet, people already know that I'm doing nursing, was one thing that helped me. I cannot keep quiet, I keep asking questions. Remember, I told you to ask questions. Please, ask questions. Even though you know you're not asking the right people, trust me, nobody, some people you'll be thinking they don't have the idea. They do have the idea. They'll tell you that thing to make you get there. Don't look down on anybody. Don't look at anybody like they're young, like they're omokekere, like she's smaller, she's not my set. No, don't. Because that person you think is younger than you and doesn't have any brain, probably has an idea and can help you with what you're going through at that point. Please ask questions. Don't feel shy to ask your little baby sister that is around, that you're thinking she doesn't know anything. No, please don't do that. Ask people questions. At this point, I'm going to stop here. My next video, I'm going to be talking about the classes that I took in nursing school, my progress towards finishing nursing school. And I'm going to be talking about what helped my nursing school success. I did not do it alone. All praise and glory be to Allah. I didn't do it alone. Alhamdulillah. Thank you so much. Please remember to like, share, subscribe. And please tell your friends, tell your family, there's this lady bothering you guys to like and share. So please tell them to like and share. This is a little way we can help each other, like send this message around. Please. It doesn't cost anything. Subscribing would not cost you nothing. It's not subscribing in a Naija subscription. This is just pressing the button. It doesn't cost you money. So please subscribe and like and share and press the bell by the subscription button. Thank you so much. My name remains Habiba. Peace.